Hi my dear students, this is Suhasini. Welcome to Awesome Math. Today we are going to see continuation of exercise 2.1. Already we have seen first 5 sums. So today we'll start with 6th sum. Okay? So use Euclid's division algorithm to find the HCF of 340 and 412. See, first what you have to do, take the largest number. Okay, so take the largest number and divide it by the smallest number. Okay, so first what we'll do? So 412 divide 412 by 340. Okay, so 2's are, it's not possible. So directly we'll take 1. So 340 into 1 will be 340 only. So 2, if I borrow 1 here, this becomes 11. So 11 minus 4 is what? 7. Okay, so this is your remainder. And this is your quotient. Okay. So already we know Euclid's division lemma, that is A is equals to B into Q plus R. Okay. So what is your A now? A is 412 is equals to, what is your B? That is 340 into Q. So Q is what? Your quotient plus remainder. What's your remainder? 72. Okay. So now what you do? You take this here, 340 here is equals to, and this number here, 72, into something plus remainder will be, okay? So again we'll do, so 340 divided by 72, okay? So if you divide it by 72 will be 288. Okay, so then subtract it. So 10 minus 8 will be 2. So again I'll borrow 1 here. So 13 minus 8 will be 5. So 2 minus 2 is 0. So 52. So this is your remainder and this will be your quotient. Okay, so quotient is what? 4. Remainder is what? It's 52. Now what you do? Again take this 72 here and take this 52 here into something will give you some remainder. Got it? So directly I'll do, so I'll just take, so 52 into 1 will be 52, so if you subtract by 72 you'll get 20. Okay, so now you have to take this here, then is equals to this here, 20 into something gives something. Okay, so here also I'll take directly. Yeah. So 20 into 2, which is 40. 40 if I subtract with 52, you'll get 12. Okay, so now again you take this 20 here and 12 here. So you'll get something here and here. Okay, so 12 into 2 is 24. So you can't take that. So again you take 1's are. So 1. So if you 12, 1's is 12, if you subtract 12 with 20, so what you will get? 8. Okay, so now take this 12 here and 8 here. If you multiply 8 with something, you'll get some remainder. Okay, so 8 2's is 16, so you can't take 2, so take 1 only. So 8 1's are 8, so 8 1's are 8, if you subtract it with 12, what you will get? It's 4. Okay. So now, take this 8 here is equals to 4 here. 4 into what, multiply what, you'll get some remainder or whatever. See, so directly if I put 4 2's are here, you'll get 8. So 8 minus 8 is 0. So until you get 0, you have to continue this. So now you got 0. So whatever the number which is next to your equal sign. So this will be your what? HCF. So HCF is 4. Highest common factor is 4. Okay. So now we'll see next subdivision. So next subdivision, divide 867 and 255. Okay. So again, you take greatest number. So what is your greatest number? You write here is equals to this one into something will give you some remainder. Okay. So divide. So 867 divided by 255. Okay, so 3 is 7, 6, 3, 5. So if you subtract that, you will get 7 minus 5 is 2, 6 minus 6 is 0, and this is 1. Okay, so 102 is your remainder. Okay, so remainder you have to write here and quotient you have to write here. So next what you have to do, this number you have to take here. So 255 is equals to next this one here. 102 into something will give you some remainder. Okay, so directly I'll do. So if you multiply it with 2, so if you multiply with 2, you'll get 204. So if you subtract, you'll get 51. Okay, so now this number you have to write here is equals to this number here. Multiply with something, you'll get some remainder. Okay, so 51 into 2. So if 51 into 2 is directly 102. Okay, so remainder is 0. So as I said, if you get remainder 0, then you have to stop there. And which is your, what is your HCF? This one, the number which is next to equal to sign. This number will be your HCF. Got it? So next subdivision, we'll see. Next, 10,224 and 9,648. Okay, so first what you do, as I said, take the largest number. So your largest number is 10,224. Okay, so is equals to 9,648. Okay, if you multiply this with something, you'll get some remainder. Got it? So directly you divide and see. Of course you have to do one only. Okay, so if you multiply this with one, the same number you'll get. So if you subtract, you'll get 576. Okay, next you take this here, 9,648 is equals to this number here, 576 into something, you'll get some remainder. Okay, so if I multiply this, I think 16's up. Okay, you try it once. So into 16, if you do, the remainder will be 432. Okay, next take this number, 576 is equals to then this one, 432 into something will give you some remainder. Okay, so you can't do it two times, so directly do one time. So 432, so if you subtract, you'll get 144. Okay, then this one, 432 is equals to then this one, 144 into something will give you some remainder. Okay, so directly if you do 3's, okay, 144 into 3, you'll get 432. So remainder is 0. So as I said, if you get remainder 0, stop it there. The number next to your equal to sign, so this will be your HCF. Okay, if you want, check out these multiplications once again. Okay, next subdivision, 84, 90 and 120. Okay, first we'll do this two. So 90 you have to divide it with 84. Okay, so 90, so if you multiply something with 84, you'll get some remainder. Okay, so of course it's 1 only. So 84, 1's a 84, so remainder is 6. Okay, this is your remainder and this will be your quotient. So quotient is 1 and this will be 6. Now take this 84 here is equals to then 6 here, multiply 6 with something to get some remainder. Okay, so of course 14 6 is 84, so remainder is 0. So if you get 0, take that number which is next to equal to sign is your HCF. So HCF is 6, but one more number is there, 120. So now what you do, take this divide it with 120. Okay, so 120 is equals to 6. If you multiply something with 6, you'll get some remainder. Okay, so directly you do 20. 6 into 20 will be 120. So 120, remainder is 0. So what is your HCF? It's 6. So directly write there, HCF is equals to 6. This will be your highest common factor. Got it? Next sum, find the largest number which divides 1230 and 1926, leaving remainder 12 in each case. Okay, so there must be one remainder 12. Okay, if you have to find the largest number which divides this two, and the remainder will be 12. Okay, so now what we'll do, we'll just subtract 12 in this both cases. Okay, so 1230 minus 12. Okay, so how much you'll get here? Here if I borrow 1 year, this becomes 2. So 10 minus 2 is 8. Then 2 minus 1 is 1. Then 2, 1. Okay. So then again take this 1926. Subtract that with 12. So 6 minus 2 is 4. 2 minus 1 is 1, 9. and 1. Okay, so now what you do, divide this 2. Okay, so which is the greater number here? This one is a greater number. So 1009 114 is equals to then 1000 218. So if you multiply something with this, you'll get some remainder. Okay, so directly you take 1 only. Okay, 2 you can't. So 1 if you take, the remainder will be 696. Okay, then take this here, 1000 218 is equals to 696 into what gives what. Okay, so again this also take 1 only. If you take, it will be 2, it takes much big number. Okay, so next if you subtract with this 2, so you'll get 522. Okay, so now you take this, 696 is equals to, again this one, if you multiply this, you'll get some remainder. So remainder, again if you take 1 only, you'll get, say 2 and all, it will be very larger number. So 1 you take, so the remainder will be 174. So 522 is equals to 174 into what gives the remainder. Okay, so into 3, directly into 3 if you do, you'll get 522. So this becomes 0. So 174 into 3 is 522. So this will be your what? HCF. So HCF is 174. Okay, so this is the largest number. So this is the largest number which divides 1230 and 1926 by remainder, leaving a remainder 12. Okay, there you just write the largest number which divides this is 174. Got it? Okay, so now we'll see next. Next sum, if B is the highest common factor of 32 and 60, find X and Y satisfying D is equals to 32X plus 60Y. Okay, so you have to find the highest common factor of 32 and 60. Okay, so then you have to find X and Y value that satisfies this equation. So first what we'll do, we'll substitute 60 is equals to 32 into something, okay, which gives something. So 32 into how much will do? Again, 1s are will do. So 32, 1s are 32. So 60 minus 32 will be 28. Okay, so that is 60 is equals to 32 plus 28. Let me take this as equation 1. Okay, so now next, this 32 is equals to then 28. So 28 into something will give some remainder. Okay, so again this is also 1s. So 32 minus 28 is 4. Again this 28 you take is equals to 4 into something to get some remainders. Again 4 into 7. 4 into 7 is 28. So 28 directly it subtracts and gives remainder 0. So what's your HCF here? It's 4. So that will be your D. If D is the highest common factor, so we got D now. Okay, so by keeping this relation, you have to find X and Y now. Okay, so let me take this one as equation 2. Okay, so let me relate this 2 now. 60 is equals to 32 plus 28. So this is our equation 1, right? So from equation 1, what I'll do, I'll just equate 28. So 28 is equals to, if I shift 32 that side, which becomes 60 minus 32. Okay, so similarly we have equation 2. So what is our equation 2? 32 is equals to 28 plus 4. So take this as equation 2. So again rearrange this, that is 4 is equals to 32, if I shift 28 that side, which becomes 28 minus 28. Okay, so by keeping this 2 in mind, so already what I know, D is equals to 32x plus 60y. We know our D value. What is our D value? So D value is 4. Okay, so write that 4 here is equals to 32x plus 60y. Okay, so now what we'll do, 4 is equals to, we know 4 is equals to what? 32 minus 28. Correct. So I'll just write here, 4 is equals to, from here, 4 is equals to 32 minus 28. We know that 28 value is 60 minus 32. Okay, from equation 1 I have rearranged it. 28 is equals to 60 minus 32. So in the place of 28, I'll just write 60 minus 32. Okay, so now what I'll do? So 32, if I remove the bracket, what it happens? 32 minus 60 minus into minus plus 32. Okay, from this, 32 plus 32 is what? 64 minus 60. Okay, so 4 is equals to 64 minus 60. So 64 can be written as what? 32 into 2. Then 32 into 2. Then minus 60. Okay, now you compare this with this equation. B they have given 4, 32 they have given. In the place of x, what you have? 2. So right there, x is equals to 2, comma, y is equals to, see, 60, 60. In the place of y, if you have nothing, which means it is 1. And you have minus also here, not plus, minus it's there. So your y value will be minus 1. Got it? So therefore the value of x and y is 2 comma minus 1. Got it? So now we'll see next sum. Ninth sum. A positive integer when divided by 88 gives the remainder 61. What will be the remainder when the same number is divided by 11? Okay, so some positive integer, if you divide that with 88, divided with 88, yes, so it gives the remainder 61. Okay, so now I'll just write here, let positive integer be a, some a. Okay, so already we have no Euclid's division lemma, right? So a is equals to b into q plus r. So they said that is a is equals to 88 into q plus, they said it gives remainder 61. So 61. Okay, so they said a positive integer when divided by 88 gives a remainder 61. What will be the remainder when the same number is divided by 11? Okay, so what we'll do, will take a divided by 11. So you have to find what is the remainder. If the same number divided by 11, what is the remainder, you have to say. So remainder you have to find. If you divide, you'll get some remainder. What is that remainder, you have to find. So let me write a as this equation, that is 88q plus 61 divided by 11. Okay, so I'll write this separately. 88q divided by 11 plus 61 divided by 11. Okay, so what happened? This will be directly cancelled. 11 ones are 11 8s are. So directly 88 you'll get. So remainder is 0. You won't get remainder here. So no remainder for this in this case. So in this first case, there is no any remainder. But think about this. So what happens if 61 divided by 11. So if you divide this, you'll get some answer. So that will be your remainder. Okay. So take Euclid's division lemma, that is a is equals to bq plus r. So your a is here, 61 is equals to b is 11 q plus r. Okay. So 61, if you multiply 11 with something, you'll get some remainder. So of course 11 5s are 55. So 11 5s are 55. 61 minus 55 is how much? It's 6. So 6, you got remainder as 6. They asked you to find remainder only, not HCF. Remember, don't write 11. The answer is, they asked a remainder. So right there, therefore the remainder is 6. Got it? So now we'll see next sum. 10th sum. Prove that two consecutive positive integers are always coprime. Okay. So first what we'll do? will take, see what is coprime first. Coprime is two positive integers are said to be coprime if their HCF, highest common factor, is 1. Okay, so any two number is said to be as coprime if their highest common factor is 1. Got it? So now we'll see. Let the number be. See, they said prove that two consecutive number. So one and the other number. Okay, prove that two consecutive integers are always coprime. Okay, so let's take that two numbers as sum k and k plus 1. Okay, see 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the consecutive number. The number and the next number will be next to it, plus 1 to it. Okay, so k and k plus 1 be the sum consecutive number we have taken. So now we'll apply Euclid's division lemma for this. A is equals to bq plus r. Okay, so your a is greater number. Always you have to take greater number. Okay, so that is k plus 1 is equals to your b is what? K. So into something plus remainder. Okay, so if I divide, what it happens? So divide k plus 1 with k. Okay, so 1's a. If you take 1's a, so you'll get k. So if I subtract k here, the remainder is 1. Okay, so this will be your remainder and this will be your quotient. So right there, k into 1 plus 1. So I can write here also. Okay, so now next step, you take this k here is equals to this remainder here. So if I multiply something with 1, I have to get k and you'll get some remainder also. Okay, see, you'll get some remainder also. Okay, I'll take this k here and 1 here. And if you multiply something with 1, you'll get some k and some remainder. So divide and see. So what you have to do, you have to get k, divide with 1. So 1 k is a k, correct? So if I subtract, I'll get 0. So what's your remainder is? So remainder is 0 and your quotient is k. Okay, so if you get remainder 0, then directly the number next to your equal sign, this one, is the HCF. So therefore, HCF is equals to 1. See what I said? Coprime is two positive integer are said to be coprime if their HCF is 1. Okay, so of course we got 1 here. So if you get 1 right there, therefore k plus 1 is coprime. Okay, so hence we have proved that k and k plus 1 are coprime, which means the consecutive numbers are always coprime. Got it? Okay, fine. So that's it. Today's class ends here. So if you have any doubt, please let me know and make a notes. Fine. Thank you. Thank you so much.